So I was going to record a completely different video, and then I scrapped it. I even rendered it. I'm not going to upload it because it's pretty fucking mean. And I think there's something more important that needs to be said, especially after I watched the latest video that Mr. Dapperton uploaded about Operation Anarchism, a.k.a. Operation Blueism, whatever, where he's showing like some proof that this guy is completely untrustworthy and a liar and all this other stuff. And it's pretty accurate. And I want to talk about the last part of the video where he uploaded audio of Operation Anarchism, a.k.a. Operation Blueism, whatever, talking about how he's a hacker and he's going to hack vegan anarchists. And he's talking about the way he's going to do it. And it's kind of, it really fucking threw me back to 1998, when I was very familiar with all of these programs, being a script kiddie, not anymore, not a hacker either. But I do understand what all these terms mean. And unfortunately, Operation Anarchism doesn't. This guy is a complete fucking fraud, and I'm going to explain why. So back in those days, I was a little bit more of a pranker. I wasn't really interested in like being destructive with the things that I was doing online. It was more kind of like I would find people who would have NetBus running on their computer and fuck with them a little bit, have a little bit of fun, and then uninstall it from their computer. Had a little bit of fun with that. It was a whole lot of fun. Also, I would create like a CD with the server file on it with an auto run. So if like my friend was, we were using the computer or whatever, and he would leave to go to the bathroom, I could put it in real quick, run it, and then go home and fuck with him. And there used to be like a war between all of us. We would install NetBus on each other's computers all the time just to fuck with each other. It was kind of a running game. And not just NetBus. We ended up using later other things too, including BackOrifice, Sub7, and a few other ones that were a little bit more obscure. But those were the really good ones at the time. So Operation Anarchism is talking about how he can hack people. And if Esoteric Entity and Filthy Heretic are trusting this guy to like hack other people's computers to show that they're pedophiles, wow. I didn't realize how much of a waste of time Operation Anarchism is, and how fucking completely disappointed they're going to be once this data drop leaks, because I have zero faith. In fact, I have absolute assurance that this is going to be a complete bust. Let me explain why. So in the latter part of this video, he's talking about how he's going to hack vegan anarchist, and he's talking about hacking other people's computers and stuff. And remember, this is the guy who's supposed to be responsible for all this information that's going to be coming out against Batco the anarchist and all these other people who are attacking Esoteric Entity. And Esoteric Entity and all these other people are basically writing these, you know, like, oh, they have complete faith in this guy. I'm going to explain to you why everything that he says in this thing is completely 100% inaccurate. It's like above and beyond how bad the egoism video was that Atomic AnCap made. Because I mean, like, there was a couple of pieces here and there that's sort of true. There's like nothing in this thing at all that is remotely true. Like everything he says about NetBus and hacking is completely, completely wrong. Let's just talk about the terms that he uses. Like he talks about like how he can send an exploit to someone. You don't really send an exploit to someone in the same way that you would like send a hole in someone's armor. That's not how that works. There is a hole in the armor, and then you can attack the hole in the armor. An exploit is something that's a vulnerability in a machine, right? And then you can attack that vulnerability. You don't send that vulnerability to someone. What you can do is you can send someone a Trojan horse, and a Trojan horse will create a vulnerability in the system, and that's what you can exploit. Just the fact that he doesn't understand these terms and even defines it, and I'm going to explain why those are wrong too. Just because he doesn't even understand the terms that he's talking about is a huge red flag. We're going to get into like factual inaccuracies in just a second. Now he says that that NetBus, and we'll get into NetBus in a second, is an exploit, not a Trojan, because exploits is something that you can control someone's whole machine with, and a Trojan horse just collects information. This is so wrong. It's not even technically wrong. I don't even know where to begin with this. Like I said, an exploit is just a vulnerability in a machine, right? And it's called an exploit because it's a vulnerability that you can exploit. All right, that's what an exploit is. It can be anything. It could be a passage to install a Trojan horse into someone's computer. It could be a passage to shut down a computer's through, you know, like packet loss type things, like we saw with the blue screen of death and nuking back in the 90s with Windows 95. It could be a hole in someone's system where you can gather information. It could be any number of things, right? And it's the same with the Trojan horse. A Trojan horse can just be designed to go into someone's computer, collect information, but can also be a way for someone to get into someone's computer and have remote access to their computer or full control over their machine, as he put it. So like a Trojan horse, it's supposed to be like a reference to the legend that, you know, there was a horse given to this thing. The soldiers hid inside of the gift horse, and then when they brought the horse in at night, they all left the horse and came in and slaughtered the entire town. We all know that story. That's the idea, is you send someone a file thinking it's going to be something fun and entertaining for them to do. But what it's really doing is it's creating a back door for someone to get into your computer and exploit your computer, to create a vulnerability, an exploit in your computer. So that's why he's completely fucking wrong. Like, he doesn't even understand the basic terms of hacking. By the way, I'm no fucking hacker, right? I was just a little script kiddie in the 90s. And, you know, I listened to tech podcasts and I kind of understand a lot about technology. And this information is not something that, you know, I need to have some sort of high level understanding of this stuff. This stuff is information that anybody can Google and find out why this stuff is completely wrong, right? Like, a lot of this stuff is even in the Wikipedia article for NetBus and exploits and Trojans. You can go and look them up if you want to try to say, like, well, he doesn't know what he's talking about, he's not a hacker. It doesn't matter. You can look it up. It's right there. It's clear as day. And any real hacker or any person who understands security or you know, HackSec and all that stuff, like, if they understand the stuff, they will confirm that what I'm saying is accurate enough to show that this guy doesn't know what the fuck he's talking about, right? So he says that NetBus is a program that was created by Microsoft to help with the computer interface. No, NetBus was a program made by a Swedish programmer named Carl Fredrik Nietker. And he created it as a quote-unquote remote administration tool. And I'm doing scare quotes, but it actually was just a Trojan horse program. It was supposed to create a vulnerability in someone's computer that you can take an advantage of, be it for good, be it for bad, be it for mischief, whatever. It could do a lot of things. You can create little windows on their computer, like fake error messages. And, you know, that was a whole lot of fun. Like, warning. You're gay. hit okay to continue. Like, you can get those sorts of kind of fun things you can do with someone's computer, or you can just straight out delete everything on their hard drive. You can replace crucial files on their computer with non-working things, and you can bork someone's computer. You can steal people's information on their credit card. Like, it was pretty nasty. Some of the things you can do, but you could also have a lot of fun with it too. So it is a Trojan horse. Okay, it's not just an exploit. It's something that creates an exploit, but it's a Trojan horse. He says that NetBus is an exploit, not a Trojan. We already did all that one. I could change my notes. He says that it's already on your computer. False. If you're running Windows 10 or Windows 7 or Windows 8, and you have Windows you have like a Windows Defender, you probably don't have it because Windows Defender would pick up on that pretty easily. This is a program that was made in 1998, okay? This is a well-known exploit. I mean, they used to talk, it was a big like topic back in the 90s. They used to talk about it all the time on like tech TV and talk about how dangerous it is and how you can get rid of it and all this. Like this is stuff that's been remedied for quite some time. No one really has it on their computer unless, you know, it was, they haven't connected their Windows 98 machine and they still use it to the internet for quite some time. And then they decided to plug it in. Chances are you don't have it. Any antivirus will pick up on it. Any malware system will pick up on it. No one really has this exploit on their system anymore. The only people that do are people who intentionally install it in someone's computer and work around Windows Defender. So yeah, no, it's not already on your computer, it has nothing to do with any of that shit. It was a malicious tool that was created for that intention. Now you can trick someone into running this. You probably could if they're really stupid and tell them how to get it to get Windows Defender to ignore it. But the fact that they're even bringing up NetBus this side of the millennium is really curious at best. NetBus, it hasn't been a thing for quite some time. It's almost obsolete. For all intents and purposes, it's an obsolete kind of tool to remote administration someone. There's a lot of other remote administration applications out there, and a real hacker would probably devise his own, because a real hacker would know that the ones that are just already swimming out on the internet have already been picked up by most antivirus and Windows Defender. By the way, don't run antivirus. Windows Defender is good enough, and if you insist, get like Malwarebytes. That's the best way to go. Antiviruses are kind of outdated. Anyways, it really took me back to the 90s. This is not really a thing. This guy does not know what the fuck he's talking about. If you really have any kind of faith in this guy, to be honest, whatsoever, you're a fucking moron, an absolute fucking moron. Especially in the audio, he even says like you can go and look it up, and if you go and look it up, you're going to be surprisingly disappointed in his ability. So if me calling him into doubt offends him, which he said it does, and it makes him want to go ahead and attack me, fucking go ahead, fucking come at me, bro. I really have zero faith in your ability. You're a fucking hack fraud. You're a fucking poser. Like, calling you a script kiddie, which is already bad enough, calling you a script kiddie would be like orders of magnitude better than what you are currently, right? Because you're just a liar and you're a fraud and you're pretending to be a hacker when you're not. You're a fucking joke. I can't wait to see this data that you drop, because I have absolutely zero faith that it's going to be anything of value whatsoever. In fact, I'm 100% sure this is bogus. And it's funny because, Esoteric Entity and all these people are like breaking off their friendship for Mr. Dapperton because of this fucking hack fraud, because they have faith in this hack. It really reminds me of like people who like get sucked into like Amway or a pyramid scheme like Amway, and then they go try to pitch it to their family, and their family is getting annoyed, and they're like trying to explain to them like, dude, this is a scam, like you got scammed, you need to stop doing this, and then they end up like losing all of their friends and family over it, and then they later find out that they were right and they have to come crawling back. This is what's going to happen. This is exactly what's going to happen. Now I've said in the past that I'm no fan of Mr. Dapperton. And it's because of the kind of YouTube fedora thing, which was what I call people who do the static cartoon image, kind of videos, like virtually every one of Mr. Dapperton's, friends that are angry with him right now. And, other people like Nightmare Fuel, basically Armored Skeptic, bad impersonations of Armored Skeptic. It's the new YouTube Fedora. He does certain things like assumes positions people have just based because like they said that, oh, I'm a feminist. Well, you must agree with this and this and this and this because feminists agree with this and this and this, and not acknowledging that there's different ones. Right. Or like a communist, like, oh, well, you must believe in the labor theory of value when there's lots of communists who don't, that sort of thing. He's not like a liar. He's not like a bad person. He's just, you know, he could just be kind of a doofus and that's my problem and a cringe cow. But that's pretty much, it's pretty benign. Whereas like Esoteric Entity is a liar himself. He's a complete liar. He's a pathological liar and he can't admit when he's caught red-handed lying that he was lying. He just throws more lies on top of it until it snowballs out of control. And that is why he's ended up having to go to Operation Anarchism in order to like save face, because this is his last vestige. Like, this is the only thing that could possibly save him. And he's putting all of his eggs in this basket because there's no other baskets to put him in. Like, there's nothing left for him except for hoping that this will come out to be truthful. And he's stupid enough to buy it. He's stupid enough to believe that this guy is legit. Operation Anarchism is a complete fraud. Fuck him. Fuck Esoteric Entity. Fuck all these people who actually believe in him. And I hate to say it, but I'm on Team Dap. As much as I don't like Dapperton, I'm on Team Dap. Because Mr. Dapperton is right. Even though I think he's acting a little bit fucking dumb right now by telling everybody to choose sides. I think that's a little out of bounds, but whatever. I'm definitely on Team Dap if I have to choose. I'm actually on no one's team. Teams are for spooks. I'll talk to you guys later. Hail Satan.